What are you-
Get it open.
On it.
Think he's gonna show? You'll bring the whole goddamn place down.
Stay focused! We'll be out of here before anyone can stop us.
Oh, Christ.
Move in! Stairs.
I heard stories, you know. Sent three home in an ambulance. The rest in body bags.
No wonder the cops want him dead.
Hey, you ever seen him?
Yeah, Gotham Zoo. With all the other flying animals.
Bruce, you can't keep doing this.
I have to. No one else will.
Every drop of blood, everything you've sacrificed, the city is safer now. But it's made you a target. And people will keep you in the crosshairs.
Yeah, well, that's the point. Let them come.
Shit!
The hell did he go? Whatever got in, don't let it get out.
was that?
Back, circle up! Oh. What the hell is this?
I know you're trying to create a myth, but be careful you don't turn into a monster.
Sometimes you need a monster.
Come at! Come on! Come on!
Mother teach you to knock. Behind you, big boy. Huh? Heyday.
You're under arrest!
If you want to be intimidating, you're succeeding. Criminals are becoming afraid of you, so are the police.
It's a scare tactic, Al. Just a performance.
Without a scratch.
So far. That doesn't belong to you.
I was wondering if we'd cross paths.
You broke the law. Here I am.
Cut the shit. The law. Don't tell me that's why you do all this. Squeeze into a suit, tie on a cape. Most people dressed up like that end up in Arkham.
Gotham needs a hero. Someone to hunt down people like you.
So that makes me, what, a villain? Sounds fun. Gotta admit it, though. You give a good chase. One day you might actually catch me.
Tonight.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous.
Then let's put you in a cage.
Thank you.
Bring it, Bat.
It's over.
I wouldn't be so sure.
Who are they now? Jesus!
I got him!
Wait, wait, wait! Do not shoot!
Why go to all that trouble for this?
Shit!
A myth can't be killed. You, however, are flesh and blood.
God damn it! I said don't shoot!
No! Wait!
I was wrong about you catching me. Not sure if it was for my sake or yours.
Who put you up to this? Answer me or I let go.
But you won't. You're not that kind of guy.
Step out of the shadows and be Bruce Wayne tonight.
Oh, that's a much harder fight.
Don't let tombstones be your family legacy.
Well then. Time to save the city.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. A humble district attorney like myself is not used to such a ringing endorsement. Even one who cut Gotham's crime rate in half. Now, for too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. But I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. And together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city. If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would Well, there he is. Fashionable and fashionably late, as always. Say hi, Bruce.
Enjoy drinking my wine. It's worth more than most of you.
No, he's kidding, everyone. No wine is that expensive. Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for your unwavering support. Together, we will change Gotham. Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Now, I know this is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you? I know you prefer the brooding billionaire angle.
Relax, it was important.
Not more than this. I know you despise these things, and truth be told, I do too.
What, a chance to show off your teeth and talk about yourself to a room full of money?
Say it ain't so.
It's called playing the game, Bruce. And tonight, if you hadn't noticed, I'm playing for City Hall. No one came here tonight to see me.
Some champagne.
They want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
And I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with a mouth that's saying, "Support Harvey Dent." We're the grease, they're the wheels. A little liquid courage before facing your adoring public. This'll help you too, Bruce. Once I've turned this city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign. Now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those. It always makes me sound like a used car salesman.
All right. How about a new face for Gotham?
Look at you. That's not half bad. I'm gonna use that.
Bruce, I meant what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, Come on. Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to
Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all, whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, I'm flattered, truly, but this night is about getting Harvey Dent elected so he can fix those potholes.
I think I speak for half the room when I say politicians are puppets.
Oh, come on now, Bob. I'm not a politician. I'm a crusader. No strings attached.
Old families like ours should flock together, you know. Like birds.
You're preaching, dear.
No, it's true. The Waynes and Zellerbachs are reminders of the golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Cape Bat Freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so. That's how you get creeps like this Batman.
Harvey Dent is our best shot. Put him in a room with anyone for 15 minutes and that grin will win him over.
He's gonna need more than that, son.
Oh, it hasn't been 15 minutes yet, Bob. We've still got time. Don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. And with Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
After all your parents did for this city, oh, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible, truly terrible.
Yeah, a tragedy like that at such a young age, it must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe... Well, I don't like to think about maybes. And I'm sure you don't either.
Well, thank you. I wish my parents could be here speaking with you too.
And thank you, Bruce, for investing in the health of this city's future.
You have our support, Mr. Dent. Go get him.
We're on our way. Not saying I doubted you, but that went better than expected.
It is a night of ringing endorsements.
Oh, well, hello. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale. Not interested. And reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private fundraiser, Miss Vale. No reporters allowed.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
No, it's all right. You can stay.
Thanks.
Bruce?
This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now. So formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight. But how are you doing? You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Everyone loves the host. You're king for a day.
Just a day? I would have guessed Bruce Wayne has that feeling year-round.
Yeah, well, I take nights and weekends off.
Mr. Wayne, You've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah. It looks like...
Spilled some wine. It'll come out.
Stick to clear alcohols, Bruce. I never stain.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce, but another guest has arrived.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything except being a businessman who loves this city. Excuse us, Miss Vale.
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. Look, at least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly.
Jesus, Harvey, inviting a known criminal to your fundraiser doesn't exactly look good for your squeaky clean image.
Let me worry about that. A word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
You know, I've been in the market for a new house. Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars. I think I'll take it. Though the decor offends my eyes. Man, all flash, no class.
Let's talk privately, shall we?
Hey, I like this guy. Ready to do business before we even introduce ourselves. But we'll get to that. Carmine Falcone.
Thank you for welcoming me into your home. You're a respectable man, I hear.
Bruce Wayne.
I know who you are. The guy is going to sell me his house.
Gentlemen, perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor. Follow me, if you will.
You should know, Mr. Falcone, my analysts say we're raising triple what Mayor Hill has... Hey, what's...
Private audience.
Oh, come on, guys. Bruce?
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes.
Harvey stays with us.
A man's home is his castle. I respect that. Seen and not heard.
Whatever you...
What did I say? Mr. District Attorney here wants to make sure the rules are followed. But in my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand? And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will.
Unlike most people I've met, Harvey actually has integrity. He's trying to make Gotham a better place.
So am I. So are you. Hey, we all carry this city on our broken backs. Might lighten the load if we do so together. I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne. Gives me indigestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship. Chalk this for me. Be a pal. I can get Harvey the mayor's seat, or I can pull it out from under him. Whatever happened to being a gracious host? Okay, imagine, this is me. And these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. I make them all move, and I want to keep everything moving if Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home, hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light, if need be. Between your businesses and mine, I bet we employ half the city.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Hey, this isn't a deal with the devil. You listen to me, kid. I know somewhere inside that tuxedo you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
I think I'll have someone see you out.
Okay. Okay. So that's how it's gonna be. People don't say no to me. Not for long.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Heed your butler's advice, kid. Oh, and I'm no longer interested in buying the house. The owner's a prick. And he's gonna get what's coming to him.
Thank you.
It's me.
Another brutal week in Gotham, folks. A string of home invasions ripple through the city's already crime-infested East End. Apparently, the bandits are using stolen GCPD battery rams to force their way in, with breaking and entering incidents up 40% over last year. Remember to keep those front doors locked tonight. And we have breaking news tonight. Five criminals are in custody this evening after a break-in at City Hall. But thanks to the efforts of the Batman, the stolen items were returned.
Not all of them. Let's see what she was really after.
Allegations that Dent may have actually been involved in the break-in. Talk about dirty politics. Does Hill's campaign really think these accusations hold any water with the voters? Or will it be perceived as a desperate attempt?
Nearly fell off a building for this?
Trying to combat the blaze at the Otisburg Processing Center, owned by Ace Chemical. Still no word on what started the fire, but whatever's burning in there has resisted everything the fire department has thrown at it. They're recommending people avoid the area and seek immediate treatment if you happen to breathe in any of that tar-black smoke.
And one mobster's murder caused quite a headache for commuters this morning. The body of Falcone family capo...
Spare grapple. I can't believe I let her take that.
...on the side of the 4th Street Bridge, sometime just before dawn.
Well, the test run at the mayor's office was a success.
Cut him down. Random stabbings are the latest headache for the riders...
I should see if I can refine the edge. Could be sharper.
Gotham police are investigating multiple cases of riders receiving abdominal wounds from an ice pick or other pointed weapon, while pressed into the tight quarters with fellow passengers. A few have died, while most have been admitted to Gotham General in critical condition. Police don't have any suspects at the time. Two more patients have gone missing from Arkham Asylum.
Let's find out what was so important.
From the half-prison, half-mental hospital to 15...
Encrypted.
Wayne Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here, in a dark, damp cave.
Yeah, well, this is the only room that really matters.
Well, then you won't mind if I skip cleaning the rest. The dusting is murder. Did you find out what that, Catwoman tried to steal?
Well, in the process...
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle. This is a map of the East Side shoreline. But it could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything flows through that port.
Maybe it's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone.
before the game switched from billiards to cutthroat. I'd recommend leaving the fistfights to your alter ego.
I don't want anything to do with Falcone.
Well, he certainly showed interest in you. That's what worries me. For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
I've never seen her before. Hopefully, she's just a tourist. I'll check the codex.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
I stay out of sight when I need to.
Define need to.
Whenever Harvey calls. That guy's exhausting.
Well, after the press conference tomorrow, I'll mark your calendar as exhausted then. The media isn't good for anyone's health. I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out now. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
I have a job to do, okay? A responsibility to this city. You know why I do this.
For the car, I presume.
Well, the car helps.
Oh, yes, you drive that thing like a bat out of hell. Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse. One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now, I haven't the faintest idea.
I think he just wants to reconnect. Criminal record or not, he's still an old friend.
A lot can change over the years. If I remember correctly, Oswald was fond of the old firecrackers in the toilet trick. I worry what he's graduated to. Even though you and young Master Cobblepot used to be close, I'd advise you to be cautious. But I know you can't abandon a good mystery until it's solved.
I'll be careful, Alfred.
When you see what's become of his park, I think you will.
Where are you, Oz? Great. There's the statue, but no Oz. Hey.
Beat it!
It isn't what it used to be.
Watch wallet cash. This goes through you.
Hey, you heard him, man. The hell are you waiting for?
You're making a mistake.
You already made one coming here. The next one kills you.
End him.
Gentlemen!
Oz.
Keep walking, all right?
This don't concern you, twerp!
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do. And you're... The moment! Come here! Think that'll do? Stay down! Used to be a nice place. Lowlifes like you don't belong. This is my park! Mine! You hear that? Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, there. Good as new. Woo! That was the right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh? Besides, someone needed to deal with the rubber situation here.
Well, thanks for the backup.
I yanked you away from your bloody ivory tower, Bruce. Least I can do is make sure you don't get shanked.
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you.
Yeah, it's been what? 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
It's a shame what happened. It was beautiful once.
And now it's a hellhole. Last thing my parents ever built. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it yourself, he did. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round-the-world vacations, unlimited potential. Now all I got is this park. And what's left in this flask. Good to know you haven't changed, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home. That oily... Oh. Wish I could have punched that grin into the back of his throat. Let him choke on it. What? You got nothing to say? Falcone made a stack of cash in corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And... it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement. Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, though. A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
I'm not your enemy, Oz.
That remains to be seen, don't it? I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side. Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers. Mr. Wayne, over here, right here.
This way.
Bruce, Bruce.
Good morning, everyone. Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars? I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. We didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. And worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. Now, Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
My parents loved Gotham. They invested their blood, sweat, and tears in this city. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. With this facility and our next mayor, we create a new face for Gotham.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
Sure, you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
I say we leave the asylum standing as a reminder that we can do better. This time, we won't fail those who need us most. All right, who's up next?
Mr. Wayne, over here!
You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remarque of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You even shook his hand. Wayne! Falcone?
I don't make friends with gangsters. He was an unwelcome guest. That's all. Next question, please.
Please, keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
How dare you? I just finished telling you about my parents' murder and you accuse them of being, what, criminals? Have some decency.
Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
My parents were entrepreneurs, philanthropists, not common criminals. It's absurd.
Mr. Wayne! Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What aren't you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. I don't know where the hell it's coming from. Damage control's my territory. We'll talk later. Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Hey, careful! Put it back.
I'm afraid we can't, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
There's gotta be a mistake.
That's what we're here to find out. Maybe we made a mistake, maybe you did.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
I meant what I said about not personal.
We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
And what do you expect to find?
That's for our analysts back at the precinct to figure out. I can't comment. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Well, Hill has a history of making his opposition disappear.
Rumors and allegations, Mr. Wayne, that's all. But if they become fact, I'll handcuff him myself, same as any other crook. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's chopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Stay back!
Take whatever you want!
You don't have to do this!
Bruce? I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
It's not a problem, really.
Ah, Bruce. First the mayor's office, now Wayne Manor. Gotham continues its streak of break-ins.
Yeah, really going for the record, huh?
Listen, Bruce... A scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this.
I appreciate the offer, Miss Vale, but trying to say I'm the good guy here...
Instantly makes you look bad. I get it. So let me say it for you. The Gazette received this supposed... evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources, there isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family, after me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran.
Hill wants me out of the picture because with my backing, Harvey wins in a landslide. All signs point to Hill.
You're a kingmaker, Mr. Wayne. And Harvey Dent is Gotham's knight in shining armor just waiting for the crown. You're the first target on Hill's list. By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation. You gotta help yourself out here, Mr. Wayne. Otherwise, people are gonna fill in the blanks, and it won't be in your favor. You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Vale.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family? We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this on the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
A warrant? What the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning? That press conference turned into a bloodbath.
Yeah, someone's coming after me.
Let's avoid making another scene, shall we? The press is already up my ass as it is. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah, then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this, I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it. He has no right to issue search warrants without my okay.
Okay, I believe you, Harvey. Mayor Hill's trying to screw us both over with this move.
And then he's made two enemies. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? It just doesn't make sense. I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
It's got to be politically motivated. Hill can't match your fundraising, so he's trying to take out your biggest donor.
I don't know. This is a new low, even for Hill. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. And that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign. I'm sorry I can't do more, Bruce. My hands are tied.
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry. I got a habit of being late.
No. Just glad you made it.
You didn't tell me you were bringing a friend to dinner.
This is Selina.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Just election nonsense. I think we'd both welcome a change of topic.
Have we met before?
This is Bruce Wayne.
The Bruce Wayne? What a treat. It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, right. Sorry.
Selina's new to town. I've been showing her around Gotham, introducing her to people.
You're an excellent tour guide, Harv.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
I'd take that ride. If only everyone was as welcoming as you. I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
It's not your fault.
It's probably long gone by now, whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Oh, sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my client. When things like this happen in my line of work, people tend to overreact.
We should just be thankful you got away with a black eye. It could have been worse.
At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment. Hey, it's Harvey.
Nice to meet the real you. This explains a lot, actually. How you can afford the fancy armor, the toys. Wouldn't Harvey be surprised? Not to mention, everyone in this cafe.